Okay, we're here with Peter QI. Peter's operating the 23 centimetre station. I'll just get you to explain what you've got going at the moment here. Peter, just go through the station and the components.
Well, we've got a TS2000 a transceiver which has the 23 centimetre module built into it. And that's about 8 watts output at the moment, and it's driving into a solid state linear amplifier which is 120 watts output. It uses 4 Mitsubishi RA series modules that are 30 watts output each, and I'm tuned on to 1296543 at the moment, which is the Langwarren beacon. And just to demo how the beams I'm using the beams, I'll just swing away. You'll hear the signal come up and then drop away. Now I'll bring it back. That's hear it peak up at that frequency, at that beam heading, and then it'll die away. So we're actually beaming south of southeast, and it dies away. Now the other thing we can demonstrate is we have a masthead preamp for receiving, which is operated from the amplifier. Now I'll just bring the beam back onto the... Okay, now I'll just flick the preamp off. That's without the preamp. When it comes back on again. That's the preamp. That's off. That's on. You can see it makes a big difference. And the flashing light over here, this is the polarisation. I put the preamp on. At the moment we're on horizontal polarisation. If I flick to vertical polarisation, you hear the signal drops right away. It's horizontal and that's vertical. And the reason for that, of course, is because, I'll do it again, here we go, vertical, horizontal, vertical, the Langwarren beacon is, of course, on horizontal polarisation. Now, if we tune down a little bit, we can get the XPD beacon in Burwood. There it is there. We need to turn the beam because it's a slightly different direction. So if I swing around a bit. Okay, we had to bring it around about 20 degrees because there's about 20 degrees difference in beam heading. And now we've got the XPD beacon. And if we switch the preamp off, it drops away to nothing. The no S meter reading. Switch the preamp on, and you've got an S meter reading. Now the antennas that we're using, we're using 4 17 element 23 centimetre Yagis in an arrangement horizontally and vertically connected, and on top of it there's a, I think it's a 19 element vertically polarised Quaggy, quad element and Yagi elements for the vertical part. And the switching is done with coaxial relays in a switch box up at the top of the mast, and of course that switches in and out the preamp as well. So in a nutshell, that's it.
Okay.
Oh, sorry,
you.
Power supply. Power supply is an MFJ 4245. That's a 45 amp 12 volt capability amplifier.
Maybe you might want to key up
key up on CW. Here we go.
Give an idea of the power draw. The left hand side is the amp meter.
I'll just go down to 1296150 and I'll send a bit of CW. Just go to CW here. Okay. It's taking 30 amps at 13.8 volts. Or if I want to crank the voltage, turn up to there. Just give it a second. About 33 amps at 13.8 volts. That's the input into the amplifier. It's not very efficient, certainly less than 50% efficient, but that's normal with the 1296 modules that they are. Is on?
Yeah, we're on now.
Okay, here are the four modules, 1, 2, 3, 4, with their various circuit boards. There's a thermal switch for switching on the fan at a higher speed. Input from the amplifier goes through a small coaxial relay, It's a Totsu model, if you know those. And it goes into a series of splitter boards on this side of the heatsink, through the amplifiers, and then there's three combiner boards, which combine the 30 watts per module, to combine together in a Teflon board, and then another Teflon board, and the output comes across and goes to one of those big Relcom coaxial relays. The Relcom's rated at 250 watts at 1.2 gigahertz, so it's more than capable of taking 130 watts. There's a bit of other control. There's a sequencing board there, which is interesting to see, because when you transmit, if I go to sideband, you'll notice the sequence of lights as I transmit. They go on in a sequence, 1, 2, 3, 4, and they go off in the opposite sequence. So this first light is switching the relays, both masthead and amplifier relays. Second one is switching this red light at the front here, which tells us that it's transmitting. Third one's doing nothing, and the fourth one is actually pressing the PTTs on the actual modules, in other words taking their bias off making them act as transmitters. So there they go on, and then of course when I take the PTT off, the PTT on the amps goes off first, and eventually the relays switch over. You can see the lights go back the other way. And that's fully adjustable, that sequencer, from about 50 milliseconds up to about a second if you need to. That's about it, I think.
Thanks very much for that.
Yeah, okay. Right, here we are with the 2 metre station. We'll go through, we'll work around from the radio to start with. We've got an IC706 here connected up to a little interface here with your PTT, headphones and microphone connected into here. And that's being logged onto the laptop here using the VK3AVV software. From there we go across to our rotator, which presently is beaming towards Melbourne. And then over next to that we've got the 160 watt amplifier, Tokyo High Power, with a 40 amp power supply underneath it to power that up. Just in front of that, out of interest, is a laminated sheet, which is, I'll just hold that up there, that's got locations of radio emitters from our location, centered around our location here. Then we can just look out and get bearings, and on the other side of that is known DX locations, or known hilltops that amateurs tend to frequent, so that's been very handy. And that's got, you look up there, like Mount Fatigue, 220 kilometres, 124 degrees, so it gives us a bit of a heads up on where to beam. And then over on the left hand side here, you've seen this before on the 70 centimetre one. This is a combined thing that we share it with 70 centimetres. I flick this switch here and I can change the polarisation of the antennas. And that's fed up via Ethernet. There's also power to the masthead preamps, but we're not using those at the moment. And yeah, that's about it. That's the 2 metre station. Up in the air we've got, on 2 metres, the antennas are 5 elements, 2x5 elements on sideband and 2x5 elements on FM. That's it.
Thank you very much.
Station.
Thank you very much, Jack. We'll be right back.